The first and the foremost important thing when you start data structures is getting hands on a good course. After this thing, I'll tell you how to approach to a question, how to practice, where to practice, and what all things that you should do to master DSA. We are going to cover some things related to competitive programming as well, so that these advanced data structures are covered and you're full ready for any company that you want to try for. Hi everyone, Naman this side. I'm a former intern at Microsoft and an upcoming software engineer at Microsoft itself. And today's topic is how to become a pro in data structures. Data structures, how can we become more good, how can we solve problems in minimal time, and what all things are required so that you can be a master in data structures and algorithm. It is a frequent question, so what we are going to do in this video is we are going to divide this video in four parts. And in all those four parts, I'll be describing something, some points, and then you can combinedly start working right from the first point. So I guess I've given you a brief introduction about what we are going to do in this video. So let's start with the first thing. The first and the foremost important thing when you start data structures is getting hands on a good course. So the first point being, you should select a good course for yourself. Now, depending upon what language that you work on, for example, if you want to work on Python, you can select a course on Python, ask your peer, ask your friends, which are the best courses of Python, and then you can start on with it. I did C++ because my friends around me, they told me to do C++, and I did the same course, DSA and Introduction to C++ and DSA course by Coding Ninjas. This is the first course that I did. So it was basically related to the introduction in which we deal with the language and the syntaxes and some kind of data structure. For example, if you talk about queues, stacks and all. This was my first course. So after that, you complete the course, it will take around 2 to 3 months. If you're a normal student and gives 1 or 2 hours a day. So it will probably take 2 to 3 months to complete a good course. So after this course, at least now you know all the data structures. From this point of time, the thing that starts is practice. From this point, when you have done your course, now you know every theory that you're required to know for your interviews, for your tests. Now what you need to do is practice the question. So after this thing, I'll tell you how to approach to a question, how to practice, where to practice, and what all things that you should do to master DSA. So two courses that I'd recommend, I'll tell you the one afterwards. But first and foremost prerequisite is that you should put your hands on a DSA course. Whether it be C++, whether it be Java, whether it be Python, you should select it yourself. And you should answer this question like, what is the use case of the language that you want to use? For example, if you want to go for web development, you can use Java because you can align it with JavaScript and also it will be more easy. If you want to build some application on Java itself, some desktop apps, so again, you can go for Java. If you want to work related to hardware, close to the hardware, then you can go on with C++, and you want to do competitive programming, then C++ is a good choice. That's what I think, and most of the other programmers around the world, because Python is a bit slow when it comes to competitive programming. So first thing, choose a good language and get a course and learn. So now at this particular time, my first point is ended. Now you know everything related to data structures. But nowadays what I've seen is in the interview and in the test, the scope of the test is not limited to just data structures. Now advanced data structures are also used in the test. So we are going to cover some things related to competitive programming as well, so that these advanced data structures are covered and you're full ready for any company that you want to try for. Second, and one of the most important points, practicing at some platform. It can be Code Studio, it can be LeetCode, it can be any other platform that you want to try, but there are few things that are related to it. I'll tell you about LeetCode because this is what I did, and I'll tell you how to use LeetCode effectively, what are things that you should think while attempting a question, and what you should do after attempting a question, and what are things that I did. All right. So firstly, whenever you go on any platform, you should distribute questions that you should cover easy questions as well. You should cover medium questions as well and the hard ones as well. Why? Because not only easy will help you, but also hard ones and medium ones will help you, because they are a bit tricky and then they can be applied to any other question as well. So what we should do is effectively, what we should do ideally is divide your questions in 5:3:2. And at least try to do 10 questions a day, because data structures is not as hard as competitive programming. So being data structures, the question that you have done a lot of times, and most of the times you'll be dealing with the same application. So I guess 10 questions a day is the minimal that I'd want you guys to do. So how can you divide this? The question is 5:3:2. For the beginners, it might be a problem, because for beginners, you can't do 3 medium and 2 hards a day. So what you can do is you can do it 6:3:1, 6 hard ones, 3 mediums and 1 hard. And if not, if you're not comfortable with hard ones, go for it. Go for 7 easy and 3 medium. But what I want you to do is, I want this 7:1:0 to go to 5:3:2 in 1 month. Okay. So because doing hard and medium question is as essential. I mean, it's very essential. So the first thing that you should do is divide your question in 5:3:2. All right. Second point. After, when you're done with the question, after with pen paper testing of the question and everything, after you have submitted the solution, if you're not getting the question, don't worry about it. You can go and check out hints, because checking hints is so normal. Just don't think about people say ki, don't watch hints, it is bad for your practice. No, you can completely watch hints and it's not bad to see solution as well. So what you have to do is, after 2 or 3 hints, you can just skip on to the solution. So you have to read editorials for it. Now, effective way of reading editorial is read the discussion, what they're trying to say. After the discussion, if you know you can write the code now, if you know how to write the code, just write it yourself. If you're not sure how to write a code, just take a look at the code, like how are they implementing things and write it. Because seeing solution is way normal. Don't think about seeing solution is bad. It is okay. It is okay. Like, trust me, seeing solution is what I did as well. Even I watched solution when I didn't know how to do it. So it's totally easy. But reading editorials and discussions and finding on which is the best algorithm, which is the best solution among all of them, which is taking less time. One way to use LeetCode is, whenever you submit a question, you'll get a chart, like where your solution is rising in terms of space or time. What I used to do was, I used to see where my solution lies in the time graph, and I used to check the solutions that are in the minimal time range. You can just click on the bar itself and you're gonna get solution from it. So just check out like why your code is slower and why their code is faster. Sometimes you'll see they have used some kind of STL. All right, standard template library. They have used some kind of STL, which is why it is making bit fast. So try to inculcate these things from other solutions. Like, checking people's solution is very essential when you code. Third thing, in LeetCode on Sundays, they have weekend test on morning. They used to have, I'm not sure if they do have it now, but if it happens, right, if it happens now, you should definitely give that 1.5 hours test. It has 4 questions. The levels of the questions are progressively increasing, and they are way good question if you talk about DSA, and it is completely, if you know DSA, then you can attempt those questions. So I'd recommend, if you use LeetCode, you should give every morning contest, because it helped me a lot. And seeing those discussions will obviously help you, because I remember my favorite 2 users are Lee215 and Hypet. So you can check out solution from these 2 users and Computerfile, if I'm not wrong. You can just go and check out their solutions, and they are one of the best solutions that you'll find on the LeetCode. And fourth most important point in this LeetCode pointer is, do as many questions as you can. Like, don't think about the numbers, think about how much can you dive in, how much can you practice, because at the end, practice is what matters. Nobody is going to talk about if you have done 500 easy, 200 hard, or 100 medium, or whatever. Nobody cares about the count. But if you know that you have done maximum, you have used your maximum potential, then that means that you're prepared. So how do you have to use LeetCode? 5:3:2 questions on the basis of difficulty level, read editorials and discussions, morning contests are way more important, and do as many questions as you can. Again, do as many questions as you can. There's no minimum limit or maximum limit to number of questions. Just do. Just try to do. Because if you're going to practice just for 4 hours a day or 5 hours a day, I bet you in 6 months, you'll be interview ready for every company and you can crack it. Whether it be Google, whether it be Facebook, whether it be any other company. Coming on to third one. So when I completed LeetCode, I had in myself that I know DSA completely and I can do things. But when you go in contest on other platforms, for example, if you talk about CodeChef, if you talk about Codeforces, so you're going to find something different. Like you're going to find maths, you're going to find geometry, you're going to find numerical problems related to number theory. You're going to find a lot of problems related to segment trees, range queries, and something of that sort. So now your scope, you have to increase your scope. For that, what you have to do is the third point, you'll have to pick a course for competitive programming. You'll have to start competitive programming. Now, I did my competitive programming course from Coding Ninjas. Parik Jain sir used to teach us, and it was a very comprehensive course and a bit hard. It was of a very good level. Like I must tell you, it was very good one. So this is what I did. The competitive programming course by Coding Ninjas has every topic that you can, that you want to learn. Fenwick trees, binary index trees, and game theory, number theory, computational geometry, whatever you talk about, it is in the course. So this is why I chose Coding Ninjas competitive programming. So after that course, my level was a bit up, because in the course there are a lot of things that you learn. So after that, after doing that course, I started with CodeChef. The first thing that I did was CodeChef. CodeChef is a competitive programming platform where contests used to take place. So the first thing that I tried was the long contest. In that days, I used to see LinkedIn's people have this rank, people have that rank, and in long challenges. So I started with long challenges. In long challenges, what you get is you get a lot of time. For example, 9-10 questions and you have to do it in 10 days. So what I think is when you use your mind to solve 10 questions and that too in 10 days, you've got a lot of time to think. So for example, if your potential is to do 5 questions from those question bank, but if you're going to practice, if you're going to invest your time in that course, if you're in that time, in that course of time, so I bet you can do that 6 and 7 too. So long contest help means sitting and thinking about the problem, ideas. So ideas are very much important when it comes to programming, because if you don't get ideas, you're not going to solve any problem. So long challenges help you in building the implementation based programming, implementational problems. It helps to build your thinking skills. Second thing, after doing long contests, what you should do is start with short contest. So CodeChef had lunchtime and cook-off. You can go and check out three hours contest it is. And you can just do questions. Questions are in the progressive level only. Apart from it, what you can do is you can use problem set as well. You can sort questions related to your ranking. And again, CodeChef has very good editorials. And the important thing is be consistent. After CodeChef, I realized I had to work on my short contest. Because in CodeChef, long contest, I was okay. And I used to get, and when you get motivated, there will be some time that you'll be under 50, that you'll be under 10, like globally. So this is what will keep you motivated if you're going to do questions early. So try it this way. After CodeChef, I tried Codeforces. In Codeforces, the Codeforces generally has short contests, which is of 2 hours, and you can directly go and attempt a virtual contest as well. So Codeforces has a lot of unique features. If I talk about, you can give virtual contest there. Virtual contest there is, the virtual contest is not happening live, but it will give you a live kind of feeling only. So it is the best part about Codeforces, and you can attempt the contest virtually. Apart from it, the question bank Codeforces has is very good. And how to practice and upskill yourself in Codeforces is, for example, if you have currently a ranking of, for example, 1300. So what you should do is, ideally, you should increase your ranking plus 200, for example, 1500, because you had 1300. So you can go and practice questions related to 1500 to 1600 range. Because the question at range of 1300, you'll obviously do. But you have to be good at 1500, 1600, which you're kind of facing problem. So increase your ranking. It is for every platform. For example, CodeChef also, if your rating is 1600, you can go and practice questions related to 1800 to 1900 rankings. This is what I did for upskilling myself. And the most important thing is don't get demotivated. There will be one day when you're going to reach a good level, but it is progressive. You cannot be the best programmer in the world in just 2-3 months. It will take time. So don't worry about it, but be consistent. Read editorials, discussions of code forces are very good. Now, when you've done it, you can go and give Div 3 and Div 2 contests. You have to give every live contest so that your ranking changes and editorials. And for all the contests that I did, I used to see on clist.by. This is a website in which every competition comes on. Clist.by. You can open it. It will show you a list of every contest that is going to go live. And for mathematics problem, I used to do projecteuler.com. So this was my overall learning path. This is how I started. This is how I ended. Trust me, the only thing that I kept in my mind was doing questions. I told you a lot of things in this video, but the most important thing that I had in myself is I have to be consistent and I have to do as many questions as I can. I used to count my questions so that I know how much figure I hit. But again, I just used to feed up myself. I used to work for 8 to 12 hours a day, sometimes 12 to 14 hours a day, just to increase my question count. I just focused on practice. I just focused on these things. I did not focus on any other thing. You can attempt live questions. You can attempt live contests because they are very good in terms of your ranking and stuff. So don't miss out on these things. It will just take 6 to 8 months to be at a good level on CodeForces or CodeChef. And trust me, with this 6 to 8 month of preparation, you can go into any company, whether it be Facebook, Google or Microsoft. It is very easy. But again, the most important part and the most hardest thing that you guys can't do is practice. So please keep practicing, keep doing questions and stay motivated and stay healthy. Because these are the few pointers that are going to help you not just in this programming era, but everywhere in your life. Be hardworking and do all these kind of stuff. And trust me, there will be one day when you're going to text me that you're in this company because of this thing. So consistency is what matters and practice. So do practice a lot of questions and start with a good course. Use LeetCode, Code Studio, Interview Bit, whatever you want to try effectively. And after that, you can just start with CodeChef and CodeForces for competitive programming. This is what you can do. And if there's anything that you thought that I told you wrong, so you can just comment it. And if you want any other video, you can just tell me. Till then, take care, guys. Bye.